chair.
I'll keep my comments brief. I was told that we're actually ahead of schedule today, and I asked him, how do you do that? And he said, if you speak too long, we're just going to come yank you out. Just, no, I didn't. But it's great to be here. I want to thank the AFL-CIO for having me. I think that I am probably the first Libertarian that spoke to this group, so I'm very excited about that. A little bit about myself. My name is Jake Porter. I am one of the Libertarian candidates for governor. And I've been a Libertarian now for several years. In 2010 and 2014, I ran for Secretary of State. A little bit about the Libertarian Party. So we've actually got major party status in the state now. And I'll be the first candidate to actually maintain or regain major party status in 48 years in the state of Iowa. So the Libertarians, we do support unions. We believe that people have the right to contract. That's a basic principle. And that's something that's being taken away here in the state of Iowa, and it's something that our politicians are trying to do in these backroom deals. One of the reasons why I decided to run for governor was I was actually asked by several people. They look at what's going on in our state. We take a look at it, we see these backroom deals that are happening. We look at the budget, we see the budget being used as a weapon. We look at all kinds of waste, corporate welfare going on, and what do our politicians, what do the members of the legislature, the governor's office, decide to go after? Domestic violence shelters. They go after mental health facilities. And they end up costing local governments more whenever they do this. That is unacceptable. It's unacceptable that they don't restore voting rights to people that have served their time and paid for their crime. That's unacceptable. But whenever they want to get something done fast, so okay, like medical cannabis for children, no, they don't get that done. But when they want to actually take away the rights of the people to unionize, they can certainly get that done in less than a legislative session. Pretty amazing, isn't it? I think it's time for a change. I think it's time that we fight against this power structure, the status quo that we have here in the state of Iowa. Let me go ahead and close my statements. I'm running out of time here.
Welcome, Jake. Do you support the changes that the legislature made to the collective bargaining law this year? And if not, what would you do to overturn or lessen the damage of it to workers and the organizations they belong to?
So I do not support the changes that we made. What I would actually welcome us to do is the governor's not a dictator. The governor's not going to dictate legislative policy. But what I would encourage the legislature to do and work with them is to bring everyone back in there to where we can renegotiate this. So that's what I would do, and I would make sure that it's an open process that members of the union are heard.
Okay, thank you for your answer, Jake. Second question is, what is your vision for education in Iowa from kindergarten through college? What changes need to be made so that Iowa doesn't fall further behind?
Yeah, it's amazing. We at one point we prided ourselves on being number one in education for several years, and we did that for a long time. But we've fallen. We're about I think 26th, 27th now in the country. That's unacceptable. One thing we need to look at is how we are doing things. Looking at the rural communities, also the rural districts. That's one thing that this union bill is actually going to hurt the local school districts. For example. Other things too is to use the technology that we've got. We can do things a lot more efficient and effective than what we've done in the past by utilizing the technology that's available to us. Kids can learn at more of their own pace now, whereas in the past we had it more of a one size fits all. I think we need to be very innovative as we move forward with our education. And we need to make sure that we provide the educational opportunities to all Iowans.
The last question. Is what is your overall vision for Iowa's economy and its future? And what changes need to be made to make that happen with yourself as governor?
We need to have a government that works for all Iowans. We need to have a government that doesn't give all of your hard-earned money away in corporate welfare and leave you with the tax bill. We need to open up ourselves. We need to look at, I've got a plan to actually phase out the Iowa sales tax that would bring jobs across our borders, right into our border towns like Council Bluffs. Council Bluffs, where I'm from, we're actually losing population to Omaha. We need to get people back here. We need to have people shopping right here in Iowa. We need to be prosperous, but we're not going to do that by these big corporate giveaways and leaving the tax bill on the poorest islands and driving them out of the state.
Thank you, Jay, for your answers to our questions. You have 3 minutes for closing.
Thank you. I wanted to talk a little bit more about why we support the unions. Why do libertarians support that? Well, it goes back to, I was reading a quote by Barry Goldwater, and I know he may have changed more of his opinions too as he got later in his life, but in 1960s, he actually said that he believed that unions kept within their proper natural bounds a positive good for the country, that they could be an instrument for achieving economic justice for the working man. And that's what I believe. I believe that by allowing people to actually band together, now I work in retail, so I can tell you about the need for unions right there. I can tell you about the cuts to labor budgets that they would do while they were making hundreds of thousands of dollars, you know, just off of my work and the work of my employees. I can tell how they would give people a title of manager, that way they could undercut their minimum wage laws. That's the type of stuff that we see here, and that's the importance of people being allowed to unionize, people being allowed to make their contracts. And I also think about, too, is our state. Do we want a state government that continues to do things, these backroom deals, that does not involve you, that gives your money to rich corporations and gives you the tax bill? We want a legislature that doesn't actually legislate, but instead just kicks these problems down the road, whether it be education, whether it be the cannabis oil for children, whether it be restoring voting rights to those that have you know, paid for their crimes for years. That's the type of thing that I want to ask, and I hope to have much of your support. You can learn more about me at jayporter.org. Once again, that's jayporter.org. I do appreciate the opportunity to come here and speak with you today. Thank you very much.
Thank you.